Hi, my name is Dmytro Kuczeruk and I represent S4GA company. I am located today in our modern manufacturing facility where S4GA produces solar, wired and portable runway lighting systems. Today I will be mainly focusing on our solar solution that is used as an alternative to wired conventional lighting systems. The solar system is completely and fully certified by ICAO, FAA or EASA regulators as a permanent fixed solution, optional to conventional systems. Who are the airports which are using those systems and which are benefiting the most from usage of solar systems? Those are airports located in areas where wired lighting is not a good fit, such as you have an island, you have a desert, you have a location where electrical supply is either unreliable or it is unavailable. For all those airports, we provide an alternative that absolutely functions without electrical supply. We don't need cables, we don't need generators, transformers or constant current regulators. Our system functions fully autonomously 365 days on solar energy only. And I'm not talking only about places such as Ethiopia or Kenya. We do have systems installed today and operating successfully in northern Canada, in northern Scotland. Those are not areas that are typically associated with solar systems, but actually S4GA solar systems work there perfectly as well. Solar system is the combination of key points, such as you need to have a good solar runway light, you need to have a control system, and you absolutely need to have an individual light monitoring. All these things S4GA collected in its solar system. Basic configuration of solar runway lighting includes different type of lights. Let me talk about what those lights are used for. Typical light that we see first during approach is an approach light. Approach light is installed on the approach section of the runway. It illuminates light in the direction of approach. It is usually white. We also offer a component which is omnidirectional that allows airplane to see the approach lighting during circling. Another very important type of light is so-called threshold end light. This light is installed either on the beginning or end of the runway. And light has two optics, one is red, another one is green. The red one indicates end of the runway and the green white indicates a beginning of the runway for the pilot. The last type of the light that we use and we have to install on the runway is the runway edge light itself. Runway edge light is installed along the edges of the runway or 3 meters from the edge of the runway. Runway edge light is usually white-white, white-yellow, white-red, depends on where it is installed. For example, white-yellow light is installed on the last 600 meters of the runway. Apart from the runway, obviously we do have taxiway, we do have turn pads, and we have an apron. All those areas has to be marked on the edges by the blue lights that are called taxiway edge light. S4GA provides to airports two types of solar runway lights, medium intensity type and high intensity. We are the only manufacturer in the world that produces solar high intensity runway light. This is absolutely unique product that today is manufactured only by S4GA. This type of light is used to equip precision approach runways or category 1 runways, and this one is used for non-precision or visual approach runways. High intensity light provides up to 10,000 candela of light output, and medium intensity is up to 1,200 candela. I would like to openly and very transparently speak about a topic that raises multiple concerns, which is certification and compliance of solar runway lighting. We often hear this question from civil aviation authorities, from consultants or airport designers. Can we use safely solar system as an alternative to wired? The answer is yes, but also this answer is conditional. Usage of solar system as permanent solution is allowed, is absolutely compliant with ICAO Annex 14, but you have to remember that every light that you use on the airport has to be compliant with four areas of certification: photometrics, chromaticity, frangibility, and jet blast. What do we mean by this? Photometrics is amount of light emitted by the fixture. Chromaticity is the color. Light has to be of exact color defined by ICAO Annex 14. Frangibility means that light has to be frangible, which is it has to break in case of impact with an airplane, jet blast. At the same time, light has to be both frangible and resistant to jet blast. So when airplane is starting with a full throttle, we don't want our light to be flying away because of jet blast. For this reason, light has to be designed in a special way and it has to withstand jet blast. When all those four parameters are met, we have to go to another level, which is reliable power supply. What is reliable power supply? Well, in wired systems, you know that you need two power sources. You need a wire and you need a backup. Normally, backup is a power generator that kicks in case of the failure of the mains. In solar system, it's a little bit different. The solar system from S4GA is powered by two batteries. Battery number one is the primary source of power, and battery number two is the backup. In case of failure of any battery of those two, the second battery will provide power to the light. Now imagine you have 100 lights and you have 100 primary power sources and you have 100 backup power sources. The probability that light will be out exists, but the probability that the entire system at the same time will be out is equals to zero. As a basic part of every solar system, S4GA offers control and monitoring system. The control and monitoring can be performed in different ways. For the tower, S4GA offers ALCMS, Airfield Lighting Control and Monitoring System, that is installed on the special monitor, which is touchscreen installed in the tower for the permanent purposes. To all those airports who are selecting solar systems, we strongly recommend to add one critical element, which is Airfield Lighting Control and Monitoring System. Why is it so critical? Why is it so critical to control the lights, to monitor them? Well, I think it's logical. Since you have the light that is independently installed in the runway, 2 kilometers from the tower, how do you know what's happening inside of it? How do you make sure that your system is safe and it's ready to operate? For this purpose, S4GA offers an ALCMS. ALCMS is a system that consists of two elements: control block and monitor block. Let's speak mostly about monitoring, because I think this is what requires most of explanation. When we talk about monitoring, what we mean is that we can monitor each and every individual light in the system. Why is it important? I think you all can agree that it's very good to understand the status of your entire runway lighting. We know exactly what is happening inside of every light, because each light is equipped with a computer that collects data such as battery level, such as status of the radio connection, if light is working or not, speed of solar charging. All this data is transferred to the database of S4GA and presented to controller in the tower or the technician with the help of very useful, like in this case, mobile pad that has a software inside of it. And so we can take a look and see each and every light. And if something happens to the light, then we can know exactly what happens and to which light. In ALCMS system in the tower, we offer 5 or even 8 steps of brilliancy selection. For a backup purpose or for rather smaller systems, we offer this handheld solution, which is called UR101. The handheld offers capability to remotely control all lights in the airfield. What is the range of the radio connection? Is there a possibility that the range of this controller is not enough to cover entire airports? Controller uses 868 MHz frequency and special mesh protocol. Mesh protocol means that signal from this controller does not have to reach the most further located light. In fact, it has to reach only nearest light, and then the signal will be retransmitted from light to light. This unit here has capability to control up to 5 groups of lights and 3 steps of brilliancies. What if I would like to activate all of my lights at the same time? I select all. All lights are activated. Now I will deactivate all the lights at the same time. I would like to activate approach only. Group approach, intensity maximum, light is on. Runway lights, I select group runway, intensity maximum, runway is activated. As you can see, this device offers a very reliable way to activate, deactivate, and control brilliancy of our solar runway lighting system.
The world's safest runway lighting.